everyone, Pizza Mama 44 here, and today I've got to do my AP Physics final project. This is due in 2 hours, so I gotta hurry, but our teacher, Mr. Yabrowski, is making us do a video on 3 physics concepts that interest us. So I chose Roblox. Leave a big fat like if you think I deserve an A. So here's my hypothesis. If I throw these trash players at different angles, I can determine the optimal trajectory for maximum distance based on the principles of projectile motion. Alright, let's start with a low 15 degree angle. Let's find ourselves a victim. Sorry, bud, it's just science. As you can see, I'm looking down 15 degrees. Yep, that's about right. Not too impressive if you ask me. Alright, now let's try a steeper angle. 45 degrees. Oh, whoa! 45 degrees seems pretty chill. But let's break this down with some real physics. So the trajectory of an object, like our little Roblox dude here, follows a parabolic path. This is due to the initial velocity and the angle at which it's launched. The optimal angle for the longest range without air resistance, as we saw, is 45 degrees. But why? Because at this angle, the horizontal and vertical components of the initial velocity are equal, maximizing the range. The initial velocity, V, can be split into horizontal, Vx, and vertical, Vy, components. At 45 degrees, Vx equals Vy. The horizontal component determines how far the object travels, actually, and the vertical component determines how long it stays in the air, if that makes sense. Here's a little formula I whipped up to explain this concept. Alright, the range, which is R, of the projectile is given by R is equal to V to the second power times sine to whatever that is. I don't know what that is. Divided by G. G is the acceleration due to gravity, if you did not know that. Alright, now let's try a higher angle, like 75 degrees. Alright, 75 degrees. Look at how bad that was. He barely went any distance at all. Notice how the player goes super high, but doesn't travel far. That's because most of the initial velocity is now vertical. Okay, now things are about to get pretty crazy. Because I'm gonna buy low gravity mode. Cha-ching! This should be interesting. Now that I have low gravity on, the formula in for range changes because G is smaller. This means the same initial velocity and angle will result in a longer range. Alright, let's see what happens now that we're on low gravity. The math does not lie. Also, a little disclaimer, this game is completely representative of real life. So, yeah, there's literally no difference. All right, Mr. Yabrowski, I assume that wasn't enough for you because you kind of have a weird obsession with physics, but I got another gem for you. The law of conservation of mass. So if I just sell here real quick, basically mass can't be created or destroyed, only changed from one form to another. So in Roblox Eat the World, when my character eats all this stuff and gets bigger, it's a fun way to think about mass being converted, not just magically appearing, even though the world magically resets every 5 minutes. Just ignore that. No mass is lost. It's just converted into more me. And who wouldn't want more of me? Listen, Mr. Yabrowski, I'm really tired, and I don't want to keep talking. I know this physics project isn't very typical, but by using the colorful world of Eat the World Roblox, I've captured the class's attention and hopefully taught them that physics can actually be useful in the real world, especially when you need to find the most optimal way to throw somebody. Anyway, guys, that's about it. If you want to learn about galvanized hardest square steel. I've got a banger coming out next week, so don't miss it. And if it's already out, it will be on the screen right now. Thank you all for watching. Pizza Mama, out.